Hi, in today's video I'm going to show you how I use two reverbs to get blend and size in the mix so that it appears as if all instruments were recorded in the same acoustic environment, which is especially important for home recordings of course, or remote recordings, because very often instruments are recorded one by one and even in different studios. I will show you how I set up reverbs, why I set them up like I do, and how I then use them in the mix, and I'll let you listen to the differences. So let's go! So I've been using the blend size technique for reverb for I think almost 10 years now, after I originally read about it in this book, Mixing Secrets for the Small Studio by Mike Senior. I think there's a second edition of this book now, and I will link it in the description below so you'll be able to find it as well. And I've always liked this technique and have been using it ever since, because it was so well thought out and so conceptually interesting to me. Now it's not the only reverb technique I use, because I usually have, I don't know, sometimes 5-6 reverbs in my mixes, but two of them are usually reserved for this technique. And the idea is that you can create blend and size in a mix by simulating two properties of the acoustic environment when you hear a reverb. The first one being the early reflections of the reverb, which are like the initial bounces back of the sound from walls that you're in. And that part of the reverb is used as blend. And then there's a second part, which is more the longer tail of the reverb, which is created by all those sounds bouncing back multiple times from all the surfaces in the room. And that's usually more diffuse. And that part of the reverb is used to create size, like a space around the tracks that you've recorded. And the nice thing is that you can do this separately for every track. So you can blend every track more or less into the mix. And that basically pushes it a bit away from the listener or brings it up really close. And you can also create more or less space around an instrument with the size reverb. Now I typically put both of these reverbs on almost every track so that you really get a sense as if they had been recorded in the same acoustic space, even though their blend and size may actually differ for each instrument. Now up next I'm going to demonstrate this technique in a Cubase project, which contains the basic tracks of a new Awash song that we've released today actually. This one was not produced over here in Lanewood Studios. I did record the guitar tracks over here, but the rest of the production was done by our bass player at Perfect Sounds Unleashed. And I'll link his socials below, and I will also link the track below, so if you want to hear the finished track, please go and have a listen and boost some of our plays on Spotify, please. But let's have a look at the project. Okay, so over here you're looking at just the basic tracks of the new Awash song. We have drums, no send reverbs yet, all tracks have some basic processing, compressor, equalization, and in this case also Suoss. And that's basically the same for all four tracks here. And without any reverb, it sounds like this. So pretty dry, because all of these tracks were recorded in the studios of the various members. Now these tracks could really do with some blend, because they lack the cohesion that you get when you record instruments in the same room all together. You get leakage, where one instrument leaks into the microphone of another, but you also get acoustic environment, which is the same for all the instruments. And that's something that you can simulate now if it's not inherently in the recording. So let me show you what I've set up for the blend reverb. In this case, I'm using a FabFilter Pro R, but you can really do this with any reverb. Typically, you're looking for an ambience preset, or something called early reflections, or short, or dry, or something like that. But it is important that it's an acoustic environment, so it should not be a very artificially sounding reverb, and it has to be short, so really concentrated on the early reflections, and not so much on the tail of the reverb, because that's the part that we're going to add with the second reverb, being the size reverb. So I think for this one, I basically left it as it is. I just added some stereo width, mixed that to 100%, and the space relatively small. Usually I also like it to get rid of the very low frequencies and the very high frequencies with this orange curve over here, so that you don't get too many high cis frequencies or have any real low frequencies in the reverb, which is not useful. So if we now have a listen to how this sounds on the drums, for example. Now this is of course way too much, but it's just so that you can pick up on the type of sound of the reverb. And oh yeah, the pre-delay of this reverb has been set to zero because it's easier to hear that way. But you usually want to have a little bit of pre-delay, but it's typically on the low side, like 5 to 10 milliseconds or something for this blend reverb. So let's now have a listen to these drums with and without blend reverb. Starting without. Yeah, can you hear the difference? So it might be quite subtle, especially via YouTube audio, but when I turn on the blend reverb, to me the drums get set back a bit more, like not so much in your face, and they also become wider due to the stereo spread of the reverb. Now let's try another example on vocals, starting without the blend reverb.
Storm is rising, the wind is crying, stars are falling down.
Now let me now enable the blend reverb on all tracks. And I'll let you listen to the mix with and without the blend reverb. Starting without. So it's not a huge difference, but it should blend the tracks a bit more together and provide some subtle depth by pushing them a little bit more back into the mix. And if you really want to exaggerate this effect of pushing a track back into the mix, you can do more about it, of course. You can add another more obvious reverb, or you can reduce the highs, for example. A sound which is further in the background usually has less high frequencies. So let's move on to the size reverb. So as explained previously, the size reverb is a reverb that focuses on the tail of the reverb. And by adding a size reverb, you can give the impression that the instrument was recorded in a bigger room, basically. It adds space around the instrument. So if we look at the reverb which I've set up for that, which is a 7th Heaven reverb, I've picked Sunset Chamber for this one, which has a reverb time of around 1.4 seconds, so this one is longer. I've also set up a longer pre-delay, around 80 milliseconds here, to make sure that the tail gets separated from the initial dry sound. And as for the Early Reflections blend reverb, I'm also cutting the lows and the highs. And very important for the size reverb is that I want the reverb to focus on the late part. So not on the early part, because we are getting the early reflections from the blend reverb, but I want to use mostly the tail in this reverb. So let's first have a listen on the drums again. I'm just going to add this to the already existing blend reverb. Now again, this is way too much, but it's just so you can get a feel for the sound of the reverb compared to the dry sound. So without size reverb, the drums sound like this. Now another track that we can check this on is on the guitar. The guitar has quite a bit of blend, and I'm also going to add quite a bit of size reverb to make it sound a bit further away in the mix, because dry it is really up close and in your face. So let's listen to it with and without. let's turn on the size reverb for the whole mix. And listen to it with and without. Now, as you can see, I've added quite a bit of blend and size on the guitar to make it stand back a bit. Vocal, medium, drums also medium, and I've added very little on the bass guitar, because typically a bass guitar doesn't take reverb that well, and you don't want to have a lot of low end in your reverb. But still, I add a little bit of both blend and size to get the illusion that it was recorded in the same room. Now, as you may notice, when I play the full mix, the reverb effects are still quite subtle. So this is not the typical reverb that you add as a real effect, like a real nice bloom of reverb when you play the mix, because I use other reverbs for that. I typically use, for example, a vocal plate to make the vocal a bit more nice and shiny. And I add a snare plate to get that really typical snare reverb sound. And I also add a hall reverb quite a lot to get that real bloom around an instrument and make it sound huge due to reverb. More as an effect and as a simulation of a real acoustic environment. Typically the blend and size reverb I use in quite an understated way. So by now I hope that you're really curious about how this track sounds when it's fully produced and mixed and mastered. So for that, have a listen to the link in the description. And when you're done listening, you can have a look at the next video up here, which shows how I automate the reverb and much more to create a dynamic mix for yet another Awash track. Enjoy that and see you soon.